Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo. Today we're talking about how to be the high value woman to catch his eye. And this is part one because, well, I have a feeling this could get a lot bigger. I want to show you how to be as successful as those women you see, those celebrities, the leaders, and get the respect you deserve no matter what you do. Hey, you want to be the woman that gets attention, maybe his attention, and keeps that attention, or maybe just getting the respect or the happiness, getting the man. I mean, what is this high value woman like? Do you want to be a Princess Diana? Do you want to be a Marilyn Monroe or an Alexandria or Ocasio Cortez, whoever it is you want to be? Let's talk about how to be the high value woman that men desire. We need to explore what the qualities are of these women. But first, let's figure out what a high value woman is. And by the way, if you find this interesting, why not subscribe and turn on the notifications? You can get this stuff every week and support the channel. There are a lot of qualities of the high value woman. You can look at this as kind of a self-improvement laundry list. Pick the things that you feel are most important to you and work on them, and then leave the others for some other time. This list can sound kind of intimidating given all the qualities of a high value woman, but don't let it freak you out. Chances are you probably already have a lot of these qualities. You just need to learn how to demonstrate them and show them. Of course, you can't be perfect, so we're going to talk about the ideal that you can aspire to and how to get your man to see them too. The first quality of a high-value woman is she loves and respects herself. She feels good in her own skin. She enjoys her own company. She's also not intimidated by the high standards she's set for herself and for others. If someone does not love her in the same way that she loves herself, she's not afraid to walk away from that relationship. And this one is really, really important. If you've ever been in a relationship where you knew you weren't getting what you needed, that's not loving or respecting yourself, well, you know that you gotta get that. You've gotta have that in your relationship, not only with yourself, but with your partner. Funny enough, many people think that staying in a relationship and clutching onto their partner is the only way to keep their love alive, and you have to have a higher standard for yourself. This high-value woman knows that the level of respect she will get from others is contingent on the respect that she gives to herself. You've probably heard a dozen different variations of this, but ultimately, you can't love someone else more than you love yourself. It just doesn't work that way. It never does. And for this reason, this high-value woman loves and respects herself deeply and will not settle for anything less than what she knows she deserves. The next trait is she's kind and compassionate. A high-value woman knows and understands the power of compassion. She displays kindness to everyone she encounters, whether it's toward a bus driver or her best friend or the guy that's bagging her groceries. And this is not a kindness that is just to get people to like her or to be approved of. This woman knows that true lasting beauty comes from how you treat other people, and that's also how her beauty radiates out and her compassion to other people. Find a way today to show someone else some compassion, not because you need something from them, but because this comes from your heart. Still, I have to warn you about what happens when you overextend your kindness. Let's talk about this in the next trait. The high-value woman also has strong personal boundaries. Now, just like the saying goes, she doesn't want her kindness to be mistaken for weakness. She has limits to how far she's going to extend that kindness. She doesn't compromise herself, her health, or her well-being just to appear to be the nice girl. Now remember, the nice girl is a huge trap for many women, and you don't want to get caught up in it. Men can often take advantage of that kind of kindness too. You can be taken for granted by many of the people in your life if you allow them. So make sure you have strong boundaries that don't allow you to be taken advantage of. You have to know where your limits are. You can be nice and you can be firm as well. This firmness in your resolve is something that men respect and they keep coming back to for more because it communicates your true value as a person. Think about this one, how the people in your life command your respect because they maintain their personal boundaries in a healthy way. The next trait is she knows her worth. A high value woman doesn't equate her worth with her body or the amount of attention she's getting or the gossip that she passes along. She doesn't think her only worth is sex, nor does she operate from a place of fear or neediness. She doesn't need a man or anyone else to approve of or validate her, but she wants a man as part of her life. And that's different, okay? This is a tricky balance for many women, especially if you felt that whole sense of desperation when loneliness starts to show up. A high-value woman also doesn't let the opinions or remarks of others get in the way of how she lives her life. She's grounded in her worth and her value, and she knows it to be true regardless of what happens or who criticizes her. So always pay attention to that part of you that wants to be seen as nice or good. Watch out for people who manipulate you with that too. A lot of women ask me if adopting these traits that I'm talking about now will make them into jerks or bitches. And I have to remind them that if they were nice before they started working on these high value traits, you're not going to just flip a switch and become a jerk overnight. It doesn't work that way. Jerks are jerks because they started out as jerks. Even men worry about this sort of thing, and I have to reassure them. Chances are, if you're afraid of appearing to be a jerk, you may already be doing too many things that make you seem too nice because you're so afraid of looking like the jerk or the bitch. Hey, do you know what's getting in the way of the relationship you want? Are you having a tough time figuring out what's stopping you from the love you want? Go take my quiz. Find out what it is that's holding you back. Go on over to datingfire.com/helpmecarlos. Help me, Carlos. Take that quiz. I'm also going to send you some of my best information about how to get your man back and how to make your relationship work and all these mistakes that women make that push men away. You get the free ebook too. So go check it out right now. The next trait is she's self-aware and empathic. A high-value woman is aware of the effect that her thoughts, her words, and her behaviors have on other people. She's careful with what she says and with what she doesn't say. She understands that it's not just what you say, but how you say it, and she communicates with other people in a very tactful and empathic way. She possesses emotional intelligence, and she respects her feelings and her thoughts without having to make judgments about the value of them. The next trait is she's mature. A high-value woman doesn't feel the need to play games or manipulate others to get what she wants. She might wait a few days until texting back, but not because she's manipulating or she's trying to pretend to be something she's not or pretending to be busy. She just does it because that just is how it worked out. She doesn't string men along for fun, and she doesn't do things that she considers are beneath her. This high-value woman doesn't have to play games that manipulate. She does things because she knows her own value. She won't behave in ways that don't align with her values or her desires. This is one of those areas where you have to be willing to draw a line in the sand. Don't let your emotions push you into decisions you don't want to make. She knows that she doesn't have to follow dating rules to make herself more attractive or appear more unattainable. She already knows that she's special. She doesn't feel the need to prove it to anyone, not even herself. And this understanding of her value is deep in her bones. She doesn't compromise herself for it. Moreover, a high-value woman will not resort to demands or neediness to get somebody to stay in a relationship. If he wants to go, she'll let him go. She'll let him leave the relationship and do it with grace. Adios, dude. She knows you can't convince a man of your value. He has to see it himself in the way that she's demonstrating these qualities. Hey, if he's not seeing how good you are, let him go. Oh yeah, and before I show you the rest of these tips, go on, admit it, you're enjoying this, right? Hit subscribe, turn on notifications, and you can get these videos every week. How cool is that, right? The next trait is she's classy. She knows how to embrace her charm, her femininity, and her personal beauty in an authentic way. She doesn't feel this need to seek attention from other people constantly. She's comfortable in her beauty and holds herself with that, again, that grace. She doesn't feel the need to compete with other women, but she understands that all women are beautiful in their own way. And she remembers that their beauty doesn't take away from hers in the same way that her beauty doesn't take anything away from them. She's committed to lifting up other people instead of driving them down with gossip or, you know, catty comments. And she knows that there is no need to compete for love or attention. Everybody can get what they want. There's enough to go around. And next trait is she's fired up. She's passionate. A high-value woman lives a life that is aligned with her purpose and her goals and her values. She actually does set goals for herself. She doesn't accept inadequacy and low quality, and she's going to pursue what she loves with passion and excitement. Hopefully you're doing that right now. She lives a life of abundance, and she doesn't give up doing what she loves just to be with a man or to be in a relationship. She also doesn't give up her friends when she gets into a relationship. She's not knocked down for long when setbacks and challenges come her way, and she bounces back. And again, she uses this stuff as motivation to do and be better. The next trait is She embraces her vulnerability. A high-value woman knows that being vulnerable isn't being weak, needy, or being too much. Vulnerability is about being emotionally brave when it feels risky or maybe even a little scary. She allows herself to be genuine and authentic with the people she loves, giving them space to do the same thing. Again, she doesn't let fear drive her. Okay, don't let fear run your life, especially in these times. It's so easy to fall victim to what the news tells us and the media tells us. Don't do it. Listen to your heart first. Don't let fear drive your decisions. And you can risk a little bit of hurt or disappointment so that you can achieve some connection and intimacy and trust, because that's what's required. She knows that ultimately her vulnerability allows her man to be vulnerable too. A lot of women don't realize this one. If he can't see you being vulnerable, he's not going to open up to you. He's got to feel safe opening up to you, and you have to open up to him. And finally, she's not afraid to speak her mind. A high-value woman knows that she hurts other people and herself by not speaking her mind. She's comfortable expressing her thoughts, her feelings, and her opinions with others, even if she knows not everybody's going to like it, right? And if the thought of not everybody liking what she has to say scares her, she knows that's the first place she needs to get to work. Otherwise, you could be manipulated with that fear for the rest of your life. She's not afraid to ask for what she wants. She knows her needs are as important as everybody else's out there. And a high-value woman also expresses herself creatively and shows her unique outlook on the world using creativity, right? Like dance or writing or poetry or painting. This expression is a way for her soul to speak. Now, a lot of women know that these qualities are important. Very often, it's easy to lose sight of them within a relationship. Ultimately, you want to be able to present the best version of you. The high-value woman, the irresistible woman that men desire. It's okay to feel that having a man desire you or validate you on some level is something you want. We all of us, we use the eyes of other people to see ourselves to some degree. And there is a secret that many high-value women understand, but they never reveal. Some of these high-value women don't even know how to describe it. What is this secret? Do you know what it is? Well, I call it irresistible desire. There are a few simple habits that certain women have and they do every day that makes them high-value women. I coach women every single day who want to be that kind of woman. I show them that path. And it's as simple as learning what she knows, what she knows that you don't know. Unfortunately, most women don't get help soon enough. They wait too long to find out how to bring out this irresistible desire in the man they love. Men like soft feminine women, and of course, women love a good, strong man. And that essential duality is important in your relationship. You've got to relearn it and you've got to use it. And I'm here to help you find it. I can help you. You don't have to handle this alone. Women come to me for my coaching and my programs and my advice because they realize that only a man can really explain how men think and what they want. You need a guy, an insider, who can help you. That's me. I can tell you what men think of you and what we want in a relationship. Men don't think the same way that women do about their emotions, about love and trust and connection and communication, about sex and commitment. If you want to learn these secrets of irresistible desire, go check out my presentation down here. That's right, datingfire.com/irresistible. datingfire.com/irresistible. You can discover what it is that makes a man find a woman irresistible. Hey, if you're new here, do the big three. Like and subscribe. You can get this stuff every single week. I'm going to have a new video next week. Why not get it? Number two, turn on the notifications, that bell icon, so you can get notified when I release more incredible, astonishing videos coming soon. And if you're already subscribed, please share this with somebody. I give away all this great info and I need some help in supporting the channel. If we get more women to know about this great advice, it's going to help me and it's going to help me give you more to learn. Don't let the algorithm bury Carlos, as I like to say. And number three, comment below. Do you agree with these tips? Is there a video that you'd like? Do you want another part two? Leave me a comment below if you want it, or what other videos you'd like to see. I read the comments and I do try to respond to as many as I can each week. Don't forget, wait for a few more seconds. I'll put a little recommended video here right in the corner for you to click. This is Carlos Caballo. As always, live and love with passion.